Hey, how's it going? This is Sean Stewart, founder of The Creative Track and creator of Simplify, 6 weeks to stress-free productivity. I'm really excited that you decided to join us today because in this free video, I'm going to share with you my most powerful tip for doubling your productivity in your work and life. Now, when I say that your productivity is going to double by learning this one tip alone, that's actually me being conservative. The reality is that this one tip could 5 to 10x your productivity and effectiveness in your business today. But at the same time, this is not something that's going to be a bunch of new work for you to do. You see, all my time management strategies are made to help you work smarter, not harder, and simplify the process of getting things done. Look, we live in an era where we're bombarded with information at an unprecedented rate. And while this allows us to have almost anything we want at our fingertips instantaneously, the cost is enormous. Most people's reality is that time owns them. I can't tell you how many people I talk to weekly who describe this horrible feeling of having a mountain of to-do items that seems to only get bigger, and they're sitting there paralyzed because it's not possible to get it all done. It's downright destructive. The stress that this causes is impacting every aspect of their life, from finances to relationships. And some entrepreneurs that I talk to have been telling me how good a regular job is sounding after years of feeling frustrated because of their inability to be productive and manage their time well. That's just crazy. But I totally get it. Nowadays, my business is streamlined and simple. I get a lot done, which allows me to support my family at a high level. But 4 years ago, I was in the exact same position I just described. I started my business with a vision and a passion to serve the world, but the reality of the day-to-day process of juggling the various projects and tasks took its toll. There were certain things I enjoyed doing and certain things I didn't, so a lot of the important aspects of my business were avoided in favor of what I was good at. All the while, I complained that I didn't have time because the important things weren't getting done. This was a self-deception. I had time if I was willing to make the time, but the discomfort of doing the things that mattered most in my business was my ruler. You see, over time, clients were not being followed up with, deadlines and income goals were not being met, and I found myself on Fridays exhausted from the week, knowing that I'd have to work the entire weekend just to catch up. It made me feel overwhelmed and powerless to change things. I'd left a 9-to-5 grind to do what I love, but suddenly I found myself in a self-created jail cell, depleted and dreaming of an escape. So how did I get from there to where I am today? Well, the tip I'm about to share with you is the answer to that. This tip alone has transformed my business to being one in which I was scraping by month to month, to one in which I have a streamlined business that allows me to work only 3 days a week and spend the time in my business doing the things I'm really passionate about. I love what I do, and I want you to feel the same way. I hope you'll make the time to learn this tip I'm about to share you and to implement it in your life and work routine. All right? So let's jump in. So the first thing that you need to know is that it all starts with focus. Okay. So there are so many things competing and demanding your focus in life that if you don't make a conscious effort to control your focus and decide in advance which things you're going to focus on, you'll be so pulled by the demands of the world that you will soon find yourself living in reaction rather than living a life plan you've designed for yourself. Really important to understand that where you place your focus is crucial, and how proactive you are about choosing where you focus every week is going to make a massive difference in your business. So here's the old paradigm that I think most entrepreneurs are used to. You got your to-do list and you write this list and you try to cross off things as you go along. Here's the thing. This is like having a vase where you've got these pebbles and these big rocks. So the pebbles are the little things that you got to get done every week. And you've got the big rocks, the things that are really going to move your business forward. And what happens with the to-do list is that you're putting them all in the same place on this list. And so what happens is we get caught up in putting the little things ahead of the big things because there's so many of them and we just can't get through the little things to finally get to what matters most. All right, so This is where time owns you. As we move over to the new paradigm, I want you to understand that this is what is going to become your new reality, especially if you learn what I'm about to teach you. Instead of putting the pebbles first, we're going to determine what the big rocks are in our business to really be clear on the results that are going to move the needle for us. And then we're going to put those things ahead of the little things, and we're going to fit the little things in between the spaces of those big rocks. So we can still get the little things done, but we don't get confused by putting them in ahead of the things that matter most and getting caught up in the thick of thin things, like Stephen Covey put it in his great book, The 7 Habits of Highly Effective People. All right? This is where life fits to your plans. So we're going to talk about a process called the weekly reset. This is so powerful. So I hope you're ready to take some notes and implement, okay? There's 4 steps we're going to talk about today. The first is capture. The second is 80-20. The third is chunk. And the fourth is create your results template. All right, so let's take it one at a time. So in the capture phase, what we're going to do is we're going to basically say, okay, all this stuff is coming at me every day of the week, right? So whether it's stuff that's email or stuff that's actual mail, if it's somebody who's trying to reach you or you're trying to reschedule, or if it's just some kind of action item or thing that you need to get done, okay, you've got this stuff that's coming at you. It's coming at all of us, all right? So what do? Well, you put all that stuff into an actual physical inbox. Okay, so if you don't have an inbox, I highly recommend getting one. The bottom line here is that you need a place to put all it. Now, if some of the stuff that you have is virtual stuff like emails, whatever it is, I want you to take a post-it note or a piece of paper, and I want you to write whatever that thing is on that note and put that into the box as well, so that everything is in one place. All the things that you need to do are in the inbox for that particular week. All right, so you get everything, all the inputs into the inbox. And what you do is you take out each item one at a time. This is when you're doing your weekly reset process. And you ask yourself, what is it? Okay? What is it? It's a really simple question, but it's going to make a huge difference because you can determine whether it's one of two things. Okay? So if it's actionable, once you determine what it is, so you have to ask yourself, what is it? And then you're going to say, is it actionable? Can I take action on it? Right? And if it's a no, then you're going to trash it. Okay? And if it's a yes, then what you're going to do is you're going to ask yourself, what's the next action? It's that simple. And whatever the next action is, you're going to put it onto a next action list. All right? So we got all this stuff. We gather it over the week. Even if things come up in our mind like, oh yeah, I've got this great product idea. Great. Get it out of your mind. Put it on a post-it note. And then put it all into, don't worry about it during the week, because you got other things. You got the stuff that you predetermined that you're going to do this week, right? Hopefully, but you will start to now. So you got all these things that you put into the inbox, and then you take one out at a time and you say, what is it? And you say, is it actionable? Because you need to be able to be certain that you can actually do it. If it's not, eliminate it. If it is, ask yourself, what's the next action? And put it on a next action list. Now, you might have stuff in there that's not stuff you want to trash. It might be reference, stuff you want to refer to later. So in that case, you may put it into a file cabinet or into some binder. It's up to you. We're not going to talk about reference stuff right now. We're just talking about actionable items, specific stuff that you can move forward on each week. All right, so now let's take a closer look at this next action list. All right, so you pulled all your inputs, you got everything down, and then you wrote all the next actions on this next action list. So here's my example of that. We've got basic chores or to-dos, and this is really like the to-do list, right? So you might be saying, but this is just like what you said the old paradigm was. Well, hold on, it's about to get different. All right, so what we do is we move on to the next step, and the next step is to use the 80-20 rule. And what we do in the 80-20 rule is we ask ourselves two things. One, what's the core business stuff that must get done this week? And I mean must. 20% means there's 20% of what you're working on that's going to produce an 80% of the results you're seeking. It's the 80-20 rule. And there's 80% of what you're looking at or trying to do that's only going to produce 20% of the outcome you want. In other words, there's a minority that's going to lead to a majority in your anything, in anything you're doing. So what's that core 20%? So you're looking at this list and say, what's the major needle movers for me in my business this week? All right. And it's not just needle movers. It's musts too. It's like, I have to do this, right? So it's the red crisis type of stuff. Okay. And then the next question is, what are the core personal items? Another way of looking at it is, if it isn't personal, is what are the things that aren't musts, but which weigh on you and which you feel you really do need to get done this week, even if it isn't a must? Okay, so we're making that distinction to really get to the core 20 things that must happen and the core 20% of things that would really feel good if you could accomplish this week. Everything else is not going to make it past the first screening of this, okay? So we're gonna choose the things that are these musts. So I'm gonna say complete 2 blog posts, decide on logo, complete opt-in page, finish 2 videos for site. Maybe in the green sort of personal stuff, we've got groceries, we've got wash car, and we've got buy ink cartridges, okay? So we've got these distinctions. We are basically getting rid of get back to Dave, write 10 pages for book, complete press release, hire a new assistant, book 1 speech. So these things, they are basically non-issues to us, all right? Now, you might keep this sheet, this is your master sheet, and look at it next week just to jog your mind so that you remember, okay, maybe next week you'll get into hire a new assistant, but that's not what's going on this week, okay? So the next step is that we move to chunk. And what we do in chunk is we take out another piece of paper and we decide on what the result are that we want to accomplish this week. And we want to think results, not to-dos. All right, so here's the other piece of paper. And let's just say that we looked at this and we said, you know, the result that I see here that's the most important for me to accomplish this week is to update my website. All right, so we're looking at this list and we're saying, what falls under update my website? All right, so I think complete 2 blog posts, that was a red item that falls under this. Complete opt-in page, that's also something that falls under this. Finish 2 videos, all right? So we have now siphoned these 3 to-dos under the category of update website, and that's what we're calling a result. So it's 1 result with 3 action items. Let's say we're gonna also come up with a second result. The second result is get errands done, okay? And we decided that we were gonna get groceries, that we were gonna wash car, and that we were gonna buy ink, all right? So you see, we took those red and green items and we put them under these categories and we are eliminating the other stuff for this week. And these are the 2 major results that we're focusing on. Now, I'm gonna show you in the next step exactly how you lay this out in a really simple way so that it's like a dashboard for you to look at every week and really determine what you're gonna be doing ahead of time. Okay, so this is step 4 and this is where you create your results template, all right? And you wanna determine the top 4 results you're gonna accomplish this week. So you draw this matrix on a whiteboard, get a ruler and just draw this. You're gonna draw it every week and you're gonna erase it every week and start again. Here's what the columns mean. The top column is results. These are the 4 results. The middle column is for actions and the bottom column is for purpose. So I decided that update website was still my top result and top chores, well, that's gonna be my 4th result. Instead, hire assistant is actually really important this week, so we're gonna do that and we're gonna make that the second most important result and set up blog as the 3rd. Now, just so we don't feel overwhelmed with these 4 things that we now have to do, we're gonna pick the top 2, the top left 2, and we're gonna determine that these are the 2 things that are absolutely, that we're absolutely gonna get done this week without question. Okay, now it's really simple. We've really gotten down to the core things that are gonna move the needle for us in our business this week. All right, and what we do is, just like I showed you with the post-it note a second ago, we just simply write down the actions that fall under that result. So just like we had it a second ago, 2 blog posts, you know, the opt-in page and 2 complete 2 videos for the website. And then the purpose has 2 parts to it. First is, what's the end in mind? What's the reason for you needing to accomplish this result? So that you're really clear that it's productive and that it's something that's going to lead you forward in your business. In this case, the reason is to generate leads in your business. And the other part of purpose is, how is it going to feel when you do this result? it's going to feel productive. I'm going to feel productive. Okay. So you're going to go along and you're going to follow this for each one of these four things. This is going to be in your office and you're going to see this and have complete clarity. Now, this is my dashboard for the week. This is not my dashboard for the month. This is not my dashboard for the next 2 weeks. It's just this week. Okay. This is a weekly reset. All right. And just again, to reiterate, here is what we did on the last slide. We determined this one result, and this corresponds to the first result column here. Okay, this is just me just copying it over, and then we added the purpose. And that's exactly how we do it. I don't think I can explain it any clearer. Hopefully that's clear to you, and hopefully you're excited, because if you're one of those people that finds yourself overwhelmed or feeling like, gosh, there's so much to get done every week, or I don't know how to do it all, wow. I mean, you have a tool now that will change that forever. All right. So I really hope you enjoyed it. And I hope you're excited about what this process can do for your business. And what I want you to do right now is make a commitment to put the results template and weekly review into play in your business one time a week from here on out. I would choose to do it either on a Sunday night or a Friday before that coming week. All right. But if you make a habit out of this, you'll save hundreds of hours of time and end the overwhelm and frustration that plagues so many business owners. Now, if you need more help understanding how to apply this tip, or you're worried that you won't implement it without someone holding you accountable, then I highly suggest that you show up for my upcoming webinar. Okay. It's called Get That Project Done: 3 Keys to 10x Your Productivity So You Can Finish 2013 Feeling Unstoppable. It's going to be a powerful webinar that is really going to take what I'm talking about here and even go deeper and show you some of the other cool things that have really changed the landscape of my business. So I hope you'll join us. Just click the link below and you'll get all the information you need. I really look forward to it. Have a great rest of your day. And until I see you or talk to you again, just remember, success is your birthright. So go out there and create it.